back to the channel. This is Dr. Hammerstack, and today we have here the Galaxy S20 FE, the latest into the S20 lineup, and we have the greatest in the S20 lineup, the S20 Ultra, courtesy of my friend over here, Asif Gadget House. So if you guys are looking for a new gadget, like a phone or a MacBook or whatever, even buy it secondhand because it's 2020, it's nice to save some bucks to buy more stuff. So if you're looking for this and you're in Malaysia, do find him in his social media. I will leave all the links in the description down below for you guys to check out if you guys are in Malaysia. So yes, check out Asif Gadget House. Really nice guy, very friendly. So do check him out. So today we're going to do a comparison video between two phones over here. I know I should be comparing it with the S20 and the S20 Plus, but you know what? Let's go all the way to the Ultra with that nice, like, you know, leather skin over here and just compare whether these two phones, is it worth the upgrade? Because this one is coming in about 700 bucks. This one is like, when it was released, it's about 1400 bucks. Yes, it has gone down maybe to 1200 bucks depending on where you're from. Is it half of the value of this? Let's just see. So the first thing here, definitely we're going to talk about the size and the whole weight to it. And as you can see, yes, it does have a significant size difference. This one, 6.9 inches, this one about what, 6.5, 6.7. So there is going to be definitely a lot of difference in terms of the size, in terms of the whole feel of it. In terms of the grip in hand, yes, both phones do feel all right. This one here, although it's 6.9, but it does have the curved screen, so it's actually still pretty good to hold. It is pretty heavy because it does have the 5000 milliamp battery. While comparing this, you have only 4500 milliamp battery, so it does have the lighter feel to it. And if you buy this, of course, you're going to get the, you know, glass bag, more premium build. Over here, you're going to get something what they call a plastic, which basically is a plastic feel to it. And yes, I do have the plastic on the back of it. I just like it to be more protected, prevent it from any scratch, and later on, I'll just remove it. So if you guys want a more premium build to your phone, yes, go for the S20, 20 Plus, and 20 Ultra. But for me anyway, because you're going to slap on a case to your phones, so it doesn't really bother me. So I'd rather have this rather than this, and I'll explain to you guys in a bit. So yes, other than the big size, we're going to talk about the big camera over here. On the S20 Ultra, you come with your 108 megapixel wide camera, your 48 megapixel telephoto, and your 12 megapixel ultra wide. Over here on the S20 FE, you have your 12 megapixel wide, 12 megapixel ultra wide, and I think 8 or 12 on your telephoto, which for me, to be honest, telephoto doesn't really matter. It's a very similar setup to your Galaxy S20 and S20 Plus. More similar to that, comparing it, of course, to this beast here, the Galaxy S20 Ultra. And as you can see here, the size is massively different in terms of size. It just looks so much bigger, like 2 times bigger. And to be honest, looking at the S20 FE, the size of it, and it does have that ring to the cameras over here. So it does have, it does look nicer compared to the 20 and 20 Plus. It's very similar to the Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra. And talking about the raised bump, yes, I think both of them are doing still pretty all right. It's not as aggressive as, like, you know, the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. So putting this down on the table is still pretty all right. And yes, I was talking about the screen as well. As you can see here, there's a lot of bezels on the S20 FE comparing it to the Galaxy S20 Ultra. And that is because, like, over on the S20 FE, you have a flat screen. While on the Galaxy S20 Ultra and S20 series, you have a curved screen. To be honest, I prefer a flat screen because it's much easier to actually do your stuff and, you know, you don't really get much accidental touches. But if you want a bigger screen for your, you know, media consumption, your Netflix, definitely, for even for me, I do miss a bigger screen like this. And I already said before, in terms of the curved side, Samsung has done it very well. Even with the S20 Plus series and S20, they've done it very well. You don't really get too much of an issue comparing it to, like, the OnePlus 8 Pro, Xiaomi Mi 10, and even the Oppo Find X2. But yes, if you are very picky, I would say, you know, maybe I would go for a flat screen. But if you want more content in your whatever you're watching, yes, go for, like, the S20 series, the first three in the 20 series. And now let's check out the cameras on the top. And I would say the size are about the same. But when you're off the phone, you will notice, especially on the S20 FE, it does have that silver camera ring to it. On broad daylight, you will notice it even more. And for me, it's a bit annoying. Over here on the Note 20 Ultra, you don't get any of that shenanigans. And for me, to be honest, if I were to be nitpicky, I would prefer, you know, the camera to be on the side. to be honest, watching a lot of content, it doesn't really bother me, so I don't think it will bother you guys. So yes, these are about the physical side of things, and yes, they are pretty similar in most ways. You have an IP rating on both of these phones, you have your wireless charging again, which I really do like on phones. It is slower, but you know what, who cares, you can get a bit more convenient when it comes to charging. This one supports up to 45 watts, while this on the S20 FE only supports up to 25 watts. But if you guys seen tests before, you'll notice that the 45 watts and 25 watts on Samsung devices doesn't really make much of a difference. Even on the Note 20 Ultra, they have already cut back on it, so it doesn't really bother me that much. So on the S20 FE and on the S20 Ultra, both are able to go 120 Hz with HD+. Of course, on the S20 Ultra, it can go up to Quad HD, but for me, to be honest, I'd rather have the high refresh rate compared to a better resolution screen. But if you like a better resolution screen, might as well go for like a Note 10, I guess, Note 10 Plus, that would have a better screen as well, and it's cheaper. With this, yes, you're gonna get this as well, but again, like I said, you'll be stuck at 60 Hz. And the reason why I prefer 120 Hz because it just feels so much more buttery smooth compared to your 60 Hz. Watching content, again, most of the time, it will be all right. Some stuff are still not yet optimized, but the whole usage, usability, I prefer, 120 Hz panel. All right, so now I'm gonna show you both of these phones and how their screens are compared to each other. So we put some photos over here, 10 photos for you to compare. And the blue filter is off, both are set at HD+. I think both of them are set at Vivid, so we're gonna see and compare. So look at the first image and to tell me, in terms of the details, what do you guys think about the color? Do you think there's a lot of difference between both of these phones? And look at this one. For me, to be honest, maybe the S20 Ultra is a little bit more contrasty compared to the S20 FE. Now look at this color. I would say yes, this one here definitely does look a bit more, the red is a bit more intense compared to the S20 FE over here. And as well, as we look at these images, the S20 Ultra will definitely look a bit more saturated for me compared to the Galaxy S20 FE. But in terms of the deep blacks, in terms of the overall color, I think both of them are doing all right. This one's a little bit more natural, I would say, compared to the S20 Ultra. Of course, do leave a comment down below what you guys think about the whole color, the whole details on both of these phones. Do you think there is a significant difference? Do leave a comment down below. So right now we're gonna test out the mic on both of this phone. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna set the volume up to half on both of these phones. And I'm gonna test out if there is, again, any a lot of difference between the speaker volume in terms of the clarity. So I'm gonna play some clip over here and just let you guys hear how it is. And I'm gonna play from each of these phones and you guys let me know which one does sound better. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the S20 Ultra. All right, so now I'm gonna test it out on this one here and you just let me know if it does sound better. Now I'm gonna test an S20 FE. Yeah, so for me personally, I feel that the S20 Ultra definitely is louder compared to the S20 FE. This is at about half the volume. Let's go up all the way to full volume. Now let's test on the S20 FE. All right, so for me, I feel that at maximum volume, there isn't much in it for me. From what I'm hearing right now, it's a bit of a difference only. But at about half the volume mark, I think the S20 Ultra is a bit louder compared to the S20 FE. But overall, both phones, they do have that stereo speakers. So it's pretty good in terms of watching your shows, hearing your shows. It's really, really good on both of these phones. So that's all the hardware part of it. And in terms of software, both phones are very, very similar to each other. They both have One UI 2.5. Whole usage on it is very similar. You have your one-handed mode, you have Samsung Pay, you have your Samsung Pass. Everything on the S20 Ultra, you'll be having it on the S20 FE. No cutbacks, wireless DeX mode, everything again, like I said, you will have it on both of these phones. So what is the main differentiating factor? Of course, it's that Snapdragon 865 goodness on the S20 FE. Because if you're in a place like outside of the US and Korea, most of the time you get the Exynos like on the S20 Ultra. You guys have seen I did a lot of tests with the S20 Plus, with the Poco F2 Pro, Xiaomi Mi 10, OnePlus 8 Pro. You know, that phone was just really bad when it came to heating. With the Snapdragon, it has really had a lot more improvements in terms of the heating, the performance of it. So actually, I don't mind, you know, sacrificing like the premium build to it, Quad HD display for a better processor like the Snapdragon 865. This is probably what we have to go through. And yes, probably if you're in a place like me here in Malaysia, you're looking for a Snapdragon phone and you know you want the best, I would say the Galaxy S20 FE actually is one of the best phones to get if you've got the chance to get it. Because I know in certain places they don't sell it, like in India, but if you get it, just buy this phone because it's really, really good. So that is it. This is the comparison between the S20 FE and the S20 Ultra. Do leave a comment down below which phones you guys are using or are planning to get. Do leave, you know, how's your experience with it so far. Do leave anything you want to talk about these phones in the comments down below and let's have a nice chit chat. So if you did enjoy this video, do click that like and smash that subscribe button down below for more videos like this in the future. And also do follow me on my socials as well on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and also here on YouTube at Dr. Hamestech. So that is it. This is Dr. Hamestech. Stay safe, take care, and wash those hands.